The massive oil spill in Oriental Mindoro now threatening the coastlines of Liwago Island in Antique. Dennis Dato reports.
Residents of Liwago Island in Antique say the oil spill reached their shores last Saturday and has affected at least 2 kilometers of their prized white sand shores. Those involved in the cleanup say they are forced to bury the collected oil due to the lack of empty containers.
Kailangan namin kukunin yan pag may mga available na empty drum. Unahin muna namin yung pag-kolekta yung sa tabi ng playa. Abutin siguro ng 100 drum.
100 drum ang binaon nyo?
Yes, sir. Ito, halos ang area ito ay mayroong nakabaon.
Nung hindi pa nabaon, sumakit po ang dibdib ko at medyo nawawalan po ako ng boses.
The oil spill has also destroyed several hectares of seaweed plantation, the island's primary source of livelihood. In the meantime, representatives from the provincial capital of Oriental Mindoro visited the island on Thursday. They brought with them food packs, drinking water, and medical supplies for residents affected by the oil spill.
Wala rin pambiling ulam, wala rin ulam, hindi rin pwede makapangyayanda. Gutom talaga, sir.
In the town of Pola, more residents continue to suffer from the loss of livelihood. Many are complaining the government subsidy is not enough.
Sana po mabigyan nyo kami ng tulong. Kasi gawa po ng kami po talaga ang matinding tinamaan po ng oil spill. Marami pong mga tao dito talagang magugutom.
The task force created by the local government unit has discussed the possible charges it will file against the owner of the sunken empty Princess Empress.
Yun yung unang-unang tinatakal, yung pinupunta ng investigation. Yung ano yung papanagutan nila?
Pola Mayor Jennifer Cruz is also appealing for any kind of support for the residents since the town's limited calamity fund is almost gone. Dennis Dato, ABS-CBN News, Oriental Mindoro.
A fisher folk group, meanwhile, wants government intervention to address fish supply woes in the province of Oriental Mindoro. Pamalakaya says this is needed to prevent traders from jacking up fish prices amid a lower catch rate. The group adds the sunken tanker's owner should provide daily compensation to the affected residents there.
Hindi nga subsidy, dapat arawan sahod. May mga iba pang mga pangangailangan yung pamilya nila. Kung may mga anak silang nag-aaral, di ba? Pero kailangan dyan, dapat mayroong sahod, no? Na i-confiscate doon sa oil company.